bottom. I know it's hard to believe you can achieve it without them. And they gon' love who they doubt it. Better have stamina, cause success is a mountain.
Hello, my loves. Hello, my angel. It is your girl, Lisa Mbopa, and I am back with another video. So, I had to do an intro for, like, this video, Miss Teenager, do anything, because I went through, like, all of my things that I've, like, put on camera for, like, the past few months, and I didn't see an intro. So I'll have to do an intro and, like, somehow update you on what we did next and what happened next. But just for now, I'm just gonna tell you how I entered for Miss Teen and all of that. Let me just, like, because I'm beautiful. So yeah, guys, let's talk about my Miss Teenager South Africa journey, which I enjoyed. I literally have to edit this vlog, like, today and post it, like, I think tomorrow night, Saturday night, because, like, I just finished writing today and it was the last day of school. But without further ado, guys, I washed my braids and it's dripping. Let's call up. So, my Miss Teenager South Africa journey. This is how it started. So, I remember, like, going on, like, YouTube and watching, like, Kensani Mises vlogs, and I saw this one vlog, not actually a vlog, but it was one of her videos, where she was like, how I entered from Miss Teenager South Africa and how I became the first runner-up. So I was like, this is interesting. So, okay, I watched the video. I'm like, oh, Kensani, because, like, Kensani, yo, I love that chick. When she was still, like, high school, I think grade 12, I started watching her videos. And I was like, okay, so interesting. So, like, after a while, I was just, like, scrolling, like, through Instagram. And I'm, like, going through Instagram and I'm checking posts out and stuff like that. And then I saw Miss Teenager South Africa post. And something said, entries are now open. I was like, isn't this the pageant that Kensani did? And, like, I never did a pageant, like, in the past. I think, not seven. I'm going to say in 7 or 6 years, I haven't been doing pageantry at all. So I was like, you know what, let me try this out. Because after all, I'm from a small town and, like, we don't get to see, like, opportunities like this. I was like, okay, let me try this out and let's see where it goes. I did not tell a soul. The only person who knew I entered for that competition was my sister and two of my friends. One of my friends actually, like, told me, you got this, you can do this. And I was like, okay, I'm checking it out. And then, like, let's say, like, 2 weeks later, right? They were announcing the semi-finalists, and, like, I didn't follow Miss Teenager that time on Instagram at all. I didn't follow them because I thought I was not even gonna make it to the semi-finalists. I was like, okay, still they didn't post me. Like, my name was on the last list, so I knew I was not gonna get posted. Until one night, like, I was just, like, scrolling through Facebook. Yeah, Facebook, that's what I saw, it Facebook. And then I saw Annalisa Mbopa Western Cape semifinal. I was like, what? Then I went on Instagram to go make sure, because, you know, Facebook. I went to Instagram and I was like, but that's me. That's me, Annalisa Mbopa. Like, that's me. So fine. Then, like, I told my sister and we were screaming. Yo, we're so happy. And then, like, I had to send my photos and voting started, right? So voting started and people started noticing, but I didn't tell people at school yet, but some people knew. But I didn't make it obvious that I'm a semi-finalist, because what if I'm not going to become a finalist? It's fine. I did my community service and I did everything that I needed to do. And I did community service before I entered the pageant. So for me, it was nothing new. It's only, like, the pageantry stuff, a big pageant, my first ever big pageant. So it was great. It was an amazing experience being a semi-finalist. We had to do a lot of tasks, like the back to school, I remember. And we had t-shirts as well. We got t-shirts that said semi-finalists and all of that. And then as a semi-finalist, we got to have interviews. Then from the interviews, they decided who their finalists will be. And that is where the real stuff happened. Okay? The real stuff happened. Let me put on my shades for this part because I just finished writing and I feel scrumptious. Gone easy. But that's collapse. No, guys, you don't. I'm so excited. I cried, guys, because of the exams. But back to Miss Teen. So the real stuff happens. So they announced their class of 2022. And guess who was there? Your girl was there. And I was like, but I came far. Okay, now is the time that people started noticing. I was getting posted everywhere in place. I even had radio interviews. Like, a weekend could pass. Like, I would be at the radio station the entire weekend. Like, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. It was during the holidays as well. Like, I had no rest at all. Community service was packing up. Newspapers. Yo, it was everywhere. It's literally everywhere. And I remember I got, let me go get my thingy. I got this thing. From Plaid Tourism. So congratulations on Lisa for representing Plaid in the finalists of Miss Teenager. Yeah. So something like that. Something along those lines. Guys, I'm in my blankets and the sun's out and my braids are drippy. But yeah, guys. So then like people start posting me and like people like, because there was a fee that we had to pay. If you're a finalist, there's a fee that you have to pay to like go to the actual thingy that's gonna be like, it always has been Empress Palace, Johannesburg. So there's a fee of 5,500 and child, I worked my butt off. I literally was asking for donations. I was standing in town at the streets asking people for, and people supported me. Like, I never ever had so much support ever from people. Like, people I didn't even know, people didn't even know me, but they went out their way and they supported me, and I got the money, sent it to Miss Teen, and then I got my sash, baby. And the girl felt like she could conquer anything. Nothing in her way she could conquer. So guys, yeah, then that happened. You got your sash, girl got her sash, and then after that, what happened? Oh yeah, still doing community service. And then my dresses arrived, guys, and then my heels and my swimming suit and everything. Then that arrived, and yo, guys, weekends away, like I was like putting a little bit of content and creating content for you guys, like weekends away from this team. Like, I think it was 3 weeks away, and then I started like giving the content more, like, because I thought, okay, this could be an amazing vlog for kids who literally, for teenagers actually, who want to like enter for Miss Teen, because I saw there were not like a lot of videos and explaining why, what, and but yeah, then it was like a few days away, and then we still had to do a lot for Miss Teen. Actually, we had assignments, like, yep, I remember the first one, what was it? Yeah, 5 fun facts about you. That was your social media assignment. 5 fun facts about you. The second one is, what makes you feel comfortable? What clothing do you like? And then third one was your life-changing advice that you have received. And then the fourth one was, why should you be the next Miss Teenager South African? Yeah. So my Instagram account actually got hacked by someone in Nigeria. So I like did half of my task there, and then after I got hacked, I had to start like a new account because I had to. And then I did that, and then I got a new account, and then yeah, I posted my other stuff there. Before I went to Joburg, actually, I went to my primary school because that is where my first ever pageant was. It was in my primary school, and I won. So yeah. So yeah, and then we had to like upload, we had to give them like pictures of us in soft glam so that they like could post it on their platforms and everything. And yeah, and then the big weekend came. Okay, so yeah, Let me explain that one. Guys, I just ordered some food. I haven't updated you in a long time, but it would be better. I've been wearing my sash. My food is not arriving, but I look cute. I ordered hot chocolate and a chocolate croissant and the big muffin. I don't know what you call it, but yeah, let's call it a big muffin. But I don't know if you guys can hear me. But yeah. Hi guys, just a further update. I don't know why my hair is doing this. Alright, we're gonna board our flights now and then. It's the Joburg! Emperor's Palace! Oh, so excited, but I'm kinda nervous. I don't know why. But yeah, I'm still in Joburg and then we're gonna do those things. Guys, we've been using the big stairs, and here's my mama, obviously, and yeah, I'm doing a vlog!
Wow.
I'm good at me!
Wow.
Thank you so much! So we're taking the big stairs, and yeah, first time vlog, so nervous. Job. George Airport. I live in Pedro, so George is like an hour away from Pedro. So yeah, we do have an airport, but yeah. Gonna land in Oratomi International Airport in Johannesburg, and gonna get you guys it and take clips of that again. And I'm gonna claim my baggage now, like my big bags, because yes, I need that. Yeah, and I had to pay extra fees for that, because obviously. Give me something I don't really feel. But you know that. Who is this?
Bingo.
And that is Tom.
Nolutando.
Nolutando, yeah. This is Nolutando, guys. And this is Tiniko. I love, like, yeah. And I'm just exploring the place.
You just have to get my name right.
So we're taking photos and I met Shanique. And I've been following her and she's so amazing. Like the other girls. Hi, guys.
Hi. So yeah, we're just walking and exploring Emperor's Palace, right? And it is really a palace. Like, I mean, well, that's with this. Guys, look at her. We're taking a tour, guys, and yeah.
What's your YouTube channel?
There's a photo booth. This is so beautiful, guys. Like, I wish we were here. It looks like a sky. My gosh, look at the scenery. To die. This is so cute. It looks like you're outside, but you're actually inside. Look at the scene. This is so cool. First time coming here. It's my first time coming here.
It's my second time coming here, but I only came to this part. It's nice.
It's really cute. It's my first time in Joburg as well, so.
Okay. I don't know.
Okay.
Are we gonna fit here?
Aren't they gonna deliver it to the place you're gonna stay? Because I'm like,
oh, yeah. Oh, okay.
It will make more sense if you deliver it. Oh my gosh, guys, one day I'm gonna come to this place. Because
wow. if we come here, it's gonna look like a school thing.
No, guys, no, I want to stay in Joburg forever.
One day
I think you should be.
Maybe just save this content for whenever
I
start a
what?
YouTube channel.
Look at the statue. Yes, that's gonna be nice, no? Isn't this guy from The Wife?
From The Wife?
Yeah.
Yeah,
Miss Teenagers. Everybody has been calling us that. Like, I just can't get over this. Best vlog ever. Like, you guys don't understand. This place is amazing. Like, look at the statue and everything.
Last day, but I just saw the poster.
Oh, really?
Yes, I
look at this. It's not even the sky. It's literally the statue that looks like this. Literally. Allowed to walk inside that park because of the casinos and everything, but yeah, we are going back right now because yeah, people on heels kind of
the same way we came in is the same way we're going out.
And we got this cute chocolate from Shinik, and it's so cute. Like, it is so cute. I love it. Like, everything is it's cute, guys. Like, the friends and everything. Hi guys!
here, Shinique.
Wo die da gelau sehe?
Ja.
Okay. We're almost there. Yep. Almost there.
Everybody's a good seer. I can't help with that.
I have a blood screen.
They're
almost a
good seer.
Yeah,
well,
we can
go. He
beautiful place in Pledge. You don't get to see this every day. Being in Joburg for the first time is people say they like my hair, but I have to fix it up a little bit. But yeah, being in Pledge, and I think if you don't get to see places like this, but this is so beautiful. I just have to say
hi, people. I made a friend.
Hi,
she is so nice. I know the lighting is very bad here, but she is so nice. We're looking for her room. We already checked in my room, and yeah, it's nice. 4, 9, 10, 0, 8, right?
Yes.
7, 8.
Yeah, we're going out. I got my car.
We're going out, like
Sempuma. Okay, this way. Oh, finally got my thing.
Where's your room?
Yes, let's walk.
Like literally, my room is on the other side of the second floor.
That is probably so boring.
Mama,
hi. Hi. Lama. See you, Lama.
So, this
still working. Still walking. Yeah, the control. So the radio. Hey, I'm here. Hi, I did show you.
Listen.
I love you, baby. Rock it.
the video.
Yeah. Ah, yeah, cheap. I love cheap thrills. I don't need no money. As long as I get the hint of
me. Hi guys. So we're going downstairs to go eat, and the girls' friends. Hi guys.
Hi.
Hi.
Hi. Hi. What's that? Ipe yang.
Oh, guys, sorry. Mina. So yeah, we're going out to go the thingies and everything. Everyone's going down.
I miss my sister. Gosh.
Hi people, I am in my room right now. This is it. I forgot to do a room tour for you guys, so I'm gonna do that like literally right now. And yeah, I'm in my room. I'm gonna brush my teeth. I just had a shower. And yeah, this is my side of the bed, but I'm going to show you guys everything. I want a photo like of the nighttime and the view. And yeah, my roommate is taking a shower. My roommate is actually from Western Cape, and I'm also from Western Cape, so yeah, Western Cape babies. So yeah guys, yeah. Oh, is it actually cool? There's a towel actually here outside. Should I give it to you?
It's fine.
Oh, you don't need it.
It's just a little smaller.
Oh, okay. Do you want a towel?
No, the floor is.
I'm very sure you can use it because we're not going to use it.
The white?
No, because you just went out and then it went dry by itself, actually. Do you have like something that I can put on the floor? Something you're not gonna wear?
Nope.
Then take this thing.
But it's white!
Then step on it.
I don't know if I just thought you did.
We have our own towels and we barely gonna use that. I don't know.
I prefer using my own towels.
Yeah, thank you. That's what I said.
I am just not the person. I was even thinking of bringing my own bed, you know, and then I was like, no, this is a hotel.
Guys, I'm making for me and my roomie coffee and tea, and we're watching Zansu Magic.
You just gave me now.
Yeah.
I Rocket love her.
No, I love her, guys. She is so pretty. She's giving all of that.
And the dirty room.
We're gonna fix it up. We're gonna fix it up actually.
Yeah. bitch. Fuck, let me see you walk, 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 walk. Yeah, ho, yeah, I know that you can talk. You talking all that shit, but let me see if you can walk. Let me see you walk, 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 walk. You talking all this shit, but let me see if you can walk. Walking like I'm talking, I'm a big stepper.
We are young yourselves. We are bored.
Oh, look at the guests.
It is Sunday. We're going home today.
Baby, we're going home today.
Hello.
I'm going to my room because she thinks she's locked out.
Hi.
Oh, thanks God. It's with me. Everything.
Did you pack everything?
Yeah. What do you still need? Are you okay now? I have everything. Okay, let me carry this because this is still there. I even called your mom already, telling her she needs to come and help.
Tell y'all how I got away with this shit. Take a look from the bottom. I know it's hard to believe you can.